Alright, hopefully the volume's a little bit better for this one. We've got a match between NP and NS. Alright, let's see. NS with the 3 mesmes, and NP with the AP spike. This is going to be very interesting. 3 mesmes against AP spike. You don't see these builds very much at all, especially 3 mesmes. So, we got Mesmer Assassin, Mesmer Necro, Mesmer Necro. So, it'll be interesting to see what those Necro skills are, but... might see Soul Barbs, actually, which would be... Soul Barbs is pretty good with, like, a train-out build with AOD and Waste Shields, although you don't see it much these days. And usually when you do see it, it's more so with, like, Ellie skills, like Lightning Surge, that also counters Hexes. And, yeah, I think that NS could actually have a huge advantage in the AV8. If they don't take deaths on the first few spikes of NP, then they can really, like, train at NP and stop them from getting the flag in very effectively, especially since they're holding an Ellie. This Ellie is probably going to be a huge target for NS to take out. Alright, let's see, first spike going to come in a second. Yep, they're going right for that Ellie straight away. That spike really had nothing behind it. I think that, yeah, Ellie must have aegis'd very early. Yep, that's Soul Barbs. This is going to be very brutal. NP is not going to be able to hold on for very long at all against this. They're going to have to either score kills or pull back very quickly. It looks like they're all pulling back. This is actually... if they're pulling back right now, that's extremely smart by them to notice that they can't fight into this. Not many teams would notice that early. Usually teams would try and play a bit greedy and try and score some kills and pull back after they wipe it. Looks like NP is willing to pull back a little bit early. But this is probably not going to help them all that much. Or help this guy all that much. He's probably going to die, I would assume. Did I see AOF somewhere? AOF on the flagger against AOD. Pretty sure this guy has AOD. Yep. So this is really sort of a worst case situation for NP. They have AOF on the Monk Flagger against an AOD, which is really not what you want. It really makes AOF quite redundant. So there's really no way that they can fight this AV8 at all. They die basically in the first minute of AV8. So this is going to be really, really unfortunate for NP. It's going to mean that NS can boost all game if they want to, because they can easily just sit a lot of the damage and snares at the main team. But NP making a very smart move, pushing out the back door, probably going to kill some footmen. And NS is kind of... it's really hard to figure out how exactly to best respond to this kind of push. So they're pulling back their whole team, which you can't really blame them for. It's not really a situation you'll counter much, where a whole AP spike is just rushing into your back door. But it's pretty smart of them, keep the dervish over here, try and take out the footmen. But NP playing very smart in response, just pulling back after the kills. And they're probably going to play the long game and sort of run between split and hold main team, I would assume. Which actually could be pretty strong against NS. NS really doesn't want to have to defend against split with their build. They don't want to be having to split up the damage, since their build works best when all the damage characters are together. So they're going to play quite defensive. I think they've already... no, they haven't boosted yet. So this game's kind of stalling a little bit, while the teams are probably figuring out how they want to play this. Figuring out their responses. Looks like NS is going to be defending with Mesmer Monk and Warrior. Okay, this is actually very, very smart what they're doing, I think. They're keeping the two allies on split side against... this Warrior will probably go back to main team, and they're probably going to have this Mesmer come back and try and defend, because this Warrior probably won't be able to do much defending. These guys won't push in yet. So NS is still able to hold for the boost, but without this Mesmer at main team, I think he's probably running Waste Rules, but without him at main team, they lose a lot of their ability to train stuff out. So a lot of their 7v7 power is lost, just from losing one character. So Mantra of Persistence actually on the AOD, which is interesting. I'm not sure how efficient of a skill that is on the AOD bar. So while it's nice, it's a nice stalling tactic at the back door, they're probably not going to be able to get much from this. Probably benefit them a lot more If they were to send, probably the assassin, I would assume. But this is a very smart move. I think that they sent both of the air rallies out, and they've got the water ally main team, and the assassin and the mesmer. But the assassin will probably help them get flags and all that. Yeah, he's holding the flag right now because of the speed boost. And the water ally just helps them play defensive and sort of stay alive and control movement a bit, and the mesmer can also play defensive. While the air rallies, all they can really do when they come to main team is just get trained out. So it's a pretty smart move, what they've done right now, but it's all it's going to do in the end is just stall the game out more. Because they're not going to be able to win on main team or split side, it's just going to stall both ends. Well, these allies are pulling both the knights, I'm not sure, that's kind of risky. Yeah, they're playing against Wastrels, this is extremely risky and they pay for it, so definitely don't want that to happen. I think this guy's, I would assume this guy was going to get away. It's going to be very hard for Godly to kill this guy in turn. Unless he doesn't cancel and eats his spikes. Godly's going to get him actually. Wow. Nice play by Godly. And Godly gets boss. There you go. That's actually really bad for Godly though. I think, because if these guys keep splitting, it's going to... Godly's going to take a lot of damage from them if they decide to hit him. Especially if they start splitting with something else that can do damage as well. Probably either the Ellie or the Assassin Paragon. Especially if they split with the Assassin Paragon, it's going to be very hard for Godly to kill the Ellies because they can just like run around really fast with the speed boost and just kite away from the Wastrels whenever they get low, and it'll be like basically impossible for Godly to push up on them past the other damage characters with the boss on him. So this is actually really unfortunate for NS that they have the boss on the Wastrels. But they're still controlling this for now. Still, you know, winning the game. Able to keep boosting, control the main team. We see a different split. Looks like they're splitting with their main team now. Like, literally just reversing their damage characters around. So the two air values are a main team. Nope, looks like they're going up the split there. So if you don't actually have any technical way to like get an advantage or win, it sometimes can be quite nice just to run your characters around the map like this. Because it can be confusing and occasionally the other team will mess up and you can get some NPCs off it, so it's very nice to see NP doing this. It shows that they must have some pretty smart players on their team. With some good experience to be able to pull off this kind of strategy that quickly into a game. Looks like NS have sent all their monks back because NP sent all the damage out. But all of NP's monks are defending the base, so NS won't be able to get any of NP's NPCs. So the game is just stalling a bit more. I would give the advantage right now, even though they're losing in morale and a lot of losing positioning, I think that NP kind of have a slight build advantage when splitting, which is really strange, but it looks like it's being really hard for NS to score kills with their 4 damage characters. I don't know if they could ever score kills with 4 damage characters against 3 monks, even though Chumali has AOF. So basically, that means that while NS is stalling in NP's base, NP might have some opportunities to kill NPCs because of how fast they can just run back and forth. Basically, it's a lot easier for NS to screw up than NP. The game's stalling out more still. NP haven't scored a kill yet. NS has scored 2 kills, one on each Ellie. Godly should still have buffs. He's sitting pretty far back, so they really want to keep their NPCs alive. They don't want to make a power play and lose some NPCs to score kills main team, which is fair enough. I think I saw Illusion of Pain. I would assume that's from the AOD mesmer. Illusion of Pain is really sort of a lot of energy for not that much on an AOD mesmer, I think. Alright, we'll see these 3 damage characters splitting in the back of NS's base. So they got the Assassin Paragon with them right now, which is actually going to be really, really strong because NS really don't want to send another damage character back, and they can't really send back him. Well, they are actually sending back the second monk, so they're leaving one monk main team against 2 damage. But I guess it's only Mesmer and the Water Ellie. So, and that's probably won't be able to push into any NPCs like this while they've got Ali back. Except, it's just kind of more stalling. They're actually getting close to scoring a kill though. They got some pressure. Ali coming back to main team. The damage of the NP looks like they're sort of fake collapsing. They'll be able to run in and get some NPCs off this. Yeah, this is pretty big. Ali's back at the main team. So, NS is defending 2 against 3 with the boss Mesmer. This, having boss on this Mesmer is just, it's gotta be a huge pain in the ass for him right now. Because he can't push out and rough guys like he wants to. Because as soon as he runs out, he's taking 150 damage from each Ali stall. But they're actually getting a little bit of advantage now, NS is. That NP's not pushing in against the two defenders. Alright, here we go. They should be able to get something off this, especially with the assassin here. They're really able to deal with the wave shields a lot better than they were before, because of their ability to run back. I'm not sure if these LEs have their own speed boost, so they weren't really able to kite away. Nearly. Oh, there we go! Got the knight down. It's a great play. Fantastic play by them. That's really great that they could do that so easily. It's going to bode well for them with this split. Shows that it's a good combination for them to run. Going to probably have to pull back now that Goldie's giving this guy low. But probably we'll get away just fine. Yeah. We'll get away just fine with the fallback and the extra damage they have from the third damage character. So yeah, that's great that they got the knight for basically losing nothing. Now they're going to get a nice collapse off. And NS is probably going to pull back. Doesn't look like they've killed any NPCs. They might get a knight there right now. Nah, they have to pull back. It's kind of surprising that NS isn't able to kill any NPCs. You would think that they might be able to get at least one or two, considering how long they've been sort of in this position for. Yeah, so for the longer that NP can pull this split off, the worse it's going to get for NS. NS really needs to sort of change up their strategy, I think. Because this right here is, this is just going to get more risky the more NPCs go down. The more, it's going to be way more likely for Goblin to die, because they can dive further on him more easily. He's actually not sitting in the pit right now. This is actually kind of a very risky position for him to be in. Oh shit! Oh! Wow, that was 230 damage from Invokes, and gives the boss to this Ellie. That's like a worst case scenario right there, giving the boss to the split Invoke Ellie. Well, split at this point, I guess. So now he's basically going to be impossible to kill with just the Wastrels. So it's going to be very hard to defend against him now, since he can just like push up and spam his skills through the Wastrels. At least it was a nice time to die, because he did base res, but NP is getting a nice collapse off right now. So basically NS cannot defend like that again. Next time they get split by NP, they're gonna have to try something different. They're gonna have to either defend with two healers or they're gonna have to defend with two damage characters. Both of those are very not ideal though, because it means that their main team just loses more. And it might actually open up for NP to run a flag out if they do that. But they could actually just, I think that their best play would probably be to just collapse all the damage down through the back door towards their base. Especially with their footman still up, they might be able to snare a guy and score a kill, possibly. Maybe if they run their AOD, which hopefully has a snare as well, if they run that guy through the front door, it would maybe corner off NP split. But they need to do something different, because the longer this situation goes on for, the closer NP gets to actually lording it, the more NPCs they get there. So it looks like they're actually making this play. They're kind of pushing over to the side here. They can really get Blood Red down. Looks like, yeah, they want to get this footman down, I think, because it would let them do this collapse of the back door, which is absolutely enormous. The only problem, it's not really much of a problem because they can just run a flag out after, but this, yeah, this collapse will let NP run a flag out. But it should put a lot of pressure on NP, and they definitely should get a kill off this, I think. Because they're doing it with all their characters, they're not sending anyone through main team. So this is going to be huge. Ooh, almost score a kill right there. So you can see NP's getting a flag out on Blood Red, but This is definitely worth it if NS can score a kill off. Especially because they can just, you know, run a flag out again. And then NP's not going to really be able to pull the split off anymore. As long as NS get a flag out after this. They're not scoring a kill though, which is surprising. They didn't score a kill off this. I think that they still might be able to. Yeah, he looks pretty dead. These monks are just getting fucked up really badly. Yeah, he got stuck and there's really not much you can do, but this is actually, you know, it took NS a long time to do that, so NP might actually get down their footman. Which would be huge, because it means that they can kind of Mario Kart around the base when they collapse to the back door again. Which would mean that that collapse strategy isn't going to work anymore. Which would mean that NP are able to split more like that, like they were before, which was working out very well for them. I'm not sure if they still have the bus though. Which one had the bus? They still have the bus, so not totally lost for them. And it looks like they're actually... NS are not collapsing, so... It's going to be very hard for NS to get the flag out if they don't collapse. They're sending... No, they're not. They're defending with 2 against 3, so there's no way that they're going to get this flag out over here. So, looks like NP is definitely boosting, which is really, really, really unfortunate for NS. He's not going to get this flag in, there's no way. If anything, they're going to die if they try and get this flag in. So NP has recovered, they used a res... probably a res sig. Would have used a res sig to get Chameli up there. Yeah, Godly's not getting this flag in. Should... let's just drop it and run back and... I don't know, I feel like they should really... NS should really be collapsing with their main team, because this is not a split that they can hold. Ooh, getting very close, very close. This monk must be quite low on energy. Considering he's not using spirit bond anymore. Oh, they put the spirit bond, but he's quite late. They're collapsing to the back door, which is interesting. Sure what the thought process behind that is, maybe a bit of miscommunication, but they really want to be using the front door, I think, right now, so that they can get the flag in and get some control back over the mainway. So because the footmen are down, you're probably going to see NP just run through the front door, and not really... Although this guy is kind of being quite slow, might be caught out. If he loses boss, this would be enormous as well. He really needs to keep this. Oh shit, Blood Red got blocked by Ali. Huge play by Ali. Wow, that's that's really unfortunate for Blood Red. So, while NS sort of gave away the boost, which is really unfortunate, they at least did score one kill out of this. But NP is still going to be really happy with that trade-off. Getting the boost for Blood Red's death and the footman. So I would still actually give this game to NP for having the advantage, just because they can keep on, they can keep the split up again, especially if they get a Sacha down. It'll be really easy to avoid getting collapsed on like before. But they're just gonna collapse right away. They shouldn't be able to catch them there with this fallback incoming. Should open up another flag run, I think, for NP. See NP smugs running through the front door, which is pretty smart. See Accolade grabbing the flag on the front monk. And we see this Mario Kart to the front door. See if anyone eats the pin down, which looks like it was rupted. Pack gets rupted with Blood Red bases anyway. They are not running away as much as you'd think that they want to. Yeah, kind of, if one of them gets caught out, there's a pretty high chance of them dying, so I'm not sure why they would want to stick around and do a bit of damage there. Kind of a very risky play. Snaring the boss guy, probably not gonna, he's still very fast, even if he's crippled, but he does get caught out there actually. So Accolade's holding the flag. I don't know if he can get this in. This is like, they need to pull back here. If they even try and get this flag in, by the time the guy gets back down, he's gonna be caught out instead. Wow, that's actually, you don't see that very often. That was a very, very smart play by NP. Usually teams will get greedy and try and run the flag in. That was very smart for them to drop that and just pull back and give away the boost. They didn't really have any DP or any red sticks out on NS, so there's not really any point capping it anyway, but that's very nice of them to notice that it wasn't the flag that they wanted to get into. So it looks like they're pulling off this split again, but with four characters. Still have the boss. I think that would probably be better off doing it with three characters because of how well it worked before. But four characters is probably going to work pretty well considering how far behind Ali is. They might get some NPCs off it. See that collapse by NS? Nope. Thinking about it. Probably going to get this knight down. I don't see him keeping this knight up for very long. Wow. Keeping the knight alive. That's a great play by Katrina Kerr there, if he keeps this knight alive. Nope, knight goes down. So there's really no way he can keep that up against 4 damage, including in this one. So we're gonna see the running away there. Because the dervish collapsed through the back door. Nice play. Blood red getting quite low here. So even though they just have, I think, 3 damage main team, it looks like they're getting MP getting quite low to 3 damage. With, I think they had 3 monks. That's interesting. Looks like, oh, NP's getting caught out here. This is big, big risk right here. Every time they get caught out, it is such a risk of them taking a death or two, because they just know that they can get out. It's really nice that they run out right now, because if they get pushed back into their pit, they have no way to run out, because they'll just get snared and killed. So it's very nice for them to run out at the time that they did. That was great timing. We see NS defending with the same defense as Mesmer and the Monk. The AOF just getting taken off right away by AOD. So they might be able to get something in NS's base right now. But actually, Ali's following them very closely from behind. They probably won't be able to get anything out of this room. Might just try and collapse and try and kill the one monk. Which it looks like they're doing quite well against anyway, with just the Mesmer and the Water Elias damage. The NS is farming some lore damage, and even if they take some deaths here, it's not going to be a big deal, because they've got all the reses. And even if they take a wipe and fall back, it's going to be very hard for NP to end the game. Just because as soon as NS will res up, they'll still have the stronger AP up. So we see the collapse here from NP. This is a great time to collapse though, and they might get a kill off at home. But it'll be interesting because if they try and score a kill, then they're going to stop moving, which means that NS will catch up to them and put them in a risky situation. They probably, I would think that they might not want to go for a kill here, because it would be so risky. No, they tried to go for a kill, but Darkest Gate's going to keep this heal monk alive. And now they're caught out of position and take a death. Yeah, going for that kill there was very risky. And now this guy can get trained out again. Yeah, I think so. They've locked target on him right now. They have to get out. If he gets trained before he gets out, this is bad. Yeah, so these guys are going to have a very hard time leaving the base now. But NS is right on top of them. That's probably game, in fact. Because NS is going to have such a difficult time. Looks like Butter's got the boss. Butter's running the soul barbs. So, probably won't benefit him as much as it would benefit Sync or Godly. But still, he's not going to complain about that. So these air allies are not able to get out. This is a nightmare situation for NP to be in. The soul is splitting the assassin because nothing else was able to get out. They need to get a flag out or something. They basically need to draw away NS's damage right now. They need to do anything they can to draw away damage. Because the longer these allies get trained out for, they're just waiting to die, because they're definitely not going to score any kills while they get trained out like this if they're soul is splitting. Yeah, they should probably be running a flag on Blood Red or something. But they're splitting Mesmer, can't complain with that. They might force NS to send back something else. They're sending back their Mesmer in response, but Blood Red's snaring it, so that's quite a nice play, but might not be able to stand up for that long, considering he's a water ally with probably no Wastrels cancel against the Wastrels. And Ally's watching very closely as well with the Veil. So that's a very nice play by NS. Fantastic play getting the kill there. And I think that probably wasn't a pack kill. Or it might have been, I don't know. Yeah, it wasn't a pack kill. So that's more DP on this air rally over here. The Assassin's come back to main team. Might be coming back to main team just so he can get a fallback off and help his team get out. Because they're just stuck in the kill zone right now. They need to get stuff out or they're going to lose very quickly. And they know it. You can see how hard they're trying to get characters out right now. Are able to get out this early now with the help of, from the Assassin and speed boost. Alright, so they did get their same split out that they were using before, so that's very good for them. But they're still having a very hard time. They've been pushed back so far and it's nearly lore damage time. And they've already taken a lot of lore damage. So we see Ally going back, falling with Miss Mesmer. I actually think it might be better for them if they had just maybe kept this Mesmer in their own base. Just because it would mean that, well, that's a pack kill. I think that was a pack kill. I don't know how the Mesmer would have died otherwise. That's pretty rough. Had they kept the Mesmer main team, I think, and if they had stayed alive on split side, then they might have been able to kill the solo monk of NS in the pit. Because NS still would have had to send back their front monk for the 3 damage, and NP would have had 2 damage in their base. But they were in, like, a pretty rough situation anyway, and now it looks like it's probably going to be over. I don't see how NP could get more damage near what NS has. Especially taking another death off the time. So this was a very nice play by both teams. Because usually, I think the AP spike would usually lose this match in like less than 10 minutes, but they were able to hold on for 26 minutes and actually get some quite nice advantages. And a good job by NS responding, you know, collapsing through the back door and just playing nice all around to try and not give NP any chances to win the game back. You see a huge split coming out, but I don't think it's really going to get much done. Getting followed very closely by Mesmer and a monk. AD Mesmer, and they don't have any heals with them, so they're probably going to die to the NPCs and the Mesmer. Or the two Mesmers, rather. But it's nice to see them not giving up. But there goes the Ellie, very quickly taken out by Godly. Oh, we get the packed off! Looks like Godly's PI must have been on cooldown. Oh no, he must have had Aegis, sorry. They do have a monk there, I didn't see that. He must have had Aegis from Accolade. That's a nice play by Accolade and Blood Red there. Sorry, I missed that. I didn't see they had a prop monk here. But yeah, not able to survive very long, as expected. So the Soul Barb is running, I think I saw that AoE hex that slows down frontliners. So he's running a lot of cursor skills. Didn't see that every day. But yeah, that was a very nice play by both teams. That was a great match. So congratulations to NS and thanks for watching.